What up, everybody? Welcome back. Today we're talking about something that I got to experience just 2 years ago, 2016, and I gotta say, I got a different name for it. In 2016, by my own choosing, I was unemployed. In that brief moment of time from 2016 to early 2017, I got to experience unemployment and honestly got to experience how it could change your life for the better. So today I'm talking about three ways unemployment can change your life. Let's go. Before I even get started, yes, unemployment is different for every single person. My story was very different because I actually saved up some money. I had some real estate income already, so I was getting ready to essentially transition from a job to being poor. Either way, I chose to be unemployed. I quit my job, which means I don't get to get unemployment assistance. For those of you that are unemployed and got fired or let go or some other horrible situation, that sucks. And I'm not saying it doesn't. I've actually gotten to experience that as well. The whole point of this video is to share that whether or not you were fired, let go, if you quit on purpose, you can still make an excellent learning experience and rewire the way you think. I hope that helps everybody understand that I'm not just talking about the select few that can afford to quit their job. I'm talking about the entire circle, the people that quit their jobs, the people that are fired, the people that are let go, that have some kind of handicap that they're now leaving their job for. Doesn't really matter. This is the unemployment sphere, and everyone's going to be on the same level here. So with all that out of the way, the very first thing that we're talking about is something that's probably pretty obvious when you're unemployed. You're about to have a shit ton of time. I really want to focus on the time you actually get to spend in your own head. You spend all this time at a job, and then you go home. If you're like me, you can't cook, and so you have to heat up a lean cuisine. You go to bed, and then you start over and do it all over again. Help me understand where in that schedule you have time for yourself. If you don't make the conscious effort to actually make that time in your schedule, it's not there. So with all this time being unemployed, you now have time to explore your own thoughts. Figure out exactly who you are. What is your why? Why were you waking up at the crack of dawn every single day to go to a job? Yeah, you gotta get paid, but what is driving you? What is the intrinsic value that make you, you? I'll be honest, driving across country from Seattle over to Orlando, Florida, when I had just quit my job, was one of the scariest things I've ever done. I don't know if anybody's ever driven through Kansas, but there's nothing out there. And so it was just me, my car, the nasty taquitos from the gas station I just picked up, and my mind. I wasn't gonna have a job to wake up to in Florida, and so all of a sudden I had to fill gaps in my schedule and in my mind. While all that time in my mind started out with a lot of uncertainty and I almost felt kind of lost, it ended up being a super clear and bright future, and that time in my own head allowed me more clarity. Clarity into who I am. Now, with all that time in your own mind, and because other people actually have jobs, the friends that you have, you are forced to be alone. And that's number two. You find out very quickly that you can be by yourself and survive. While I was already really comfortable with being on my own, I had to travel for work, eat at restaurants by myself, which I know a lot of people just shudder thinking about, I was already kind of comfortable being on my own. For a lot of people, though, being by yourself in any situation is absolutely frightening. And that's fine. It is natural for every human being to want to socialize. It doesn't matter if you're an introvert or an extrovert fighting for attention. It is an instinct. We crave socialization. Why would you ever want to consciously be alone? Have you ever heard of something called me time? Unemployment is that feeling times a thousand. It ties back into the very first one we talked about. You have a ton more time, which means you have more time in your mind, which means you get to be more introspective. Again, dig deeper, figure out who you are, what you like to do. The funny thing is, everybody's at their 9-to-5 now, and so you are forced to be alone. And that alone time and that me time, you now get to spend time at Starbucks getting coffee and listening to music. You can start writing that book that you really wanted to and not be distracted. I like to think of myself as an extrovert, and I still found this unbelievably therapeutic. It changed my life so much that I now make sure every single morning I got a little time to myself to drink a cup of coffee, read my book. It doesn't really matter as long as I get time in my own mind. But now that I think of it, it's kind of scary. So once you work out what you're going to do with all this time and understanding that you can totally be by yourself, it's time to actually start looking at where you can invest the other pieces of the time. So number three is learning how and where you're going to reinvest your time. Immediately when I quit, I actually booked a trip to South America. I hadn't even gotten to Orlando yet and hadn't figured out my visa yet. I also booked a trip up to the Northeast because I hadn't been to those states yet. I started booking stuff and wanted to reinvest my time. It doesn't necessarily need to be traveling either. If you've always wanted to go and learn a new skill, whether that's a language or learning how to fly a plane or just learning how to ride a motorcycle, something, go pick a new skill that you always wanted to do but didn't have time for. What's your excuse now? You can even go reinvest your time in relationships that you've always wanted to grow. Sorry, I'm at a work event tonight. I can't hang out. Sorry, I can't hang out this week. I'm just so tired from work. Guess what? You don't have those excuses anymore. So make the effort to go talk to some of your friends, the relationships that you've wanted to build up. Those are just some of the examples, but you get the idea. You've got a ton of time. You've spent it in your own mind. You've figured out that being alone can actually be really great for you. Me time. And now you're learning how to reinvest your time. That's it. Those are the three ways unemployment changed my life. I realized I had a ton of time that I can now reinvest in the things I really wanted to. I had time in my own mind, learning who I am, and I was forced to be by myself. As scary as unemployment was one of the most unexpected learning experiences in my entire life so far. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you liked the video, go ahead and press like. If you want to come back and see some more content, don't forget to press subscribe. And because content is so readily available now, I actually take my audio from my YouTube videos and put it into a podcast for those of you that like to drive and listen. I'm doing something a little different for this particular episode. While I will still take this audio and add it to the podcast, I'm going ahead and also read off the 10 ways unemployment changed my life. It was an article I wrote right about the time I actually found another job and survived unemployment. If you want to check that out and go ahead and listen instead of watch, you can go ahead and check out that link in the description below. And remember, unemployment can actually end up being fun employment. That is so bad, I almost didn't even want to say it. Anyways, have a great weekend. I'll see you guys later.